Home workouts got extremely popular, especially over the last couple of months, and for most of us that even was the only chance to stay active and keep ourselves fit. Even though you can do a lot of different things with bodyweight exercises, there are some things where you really need a little bit of equipment if you actually want to train on strength and power, for example. But the good news here, you don't have to spend a fortune. There are already a few very cheap tools that will help you to build your own badminton home gym where you can train with little space and, as I said, little budget. So I want to show you my top tools for a cheap home badminton gym. Before we dive into the part about strength and power training, there are also two more things that will help your stability training a lot, and one of those things is, in my eyes, a must-have: the minibands. On our website you will also find a follow-along workout and different exercises you can do with them. They are super cheap, they fit in every bag, so around 5 to 10 bucks you will get them, so definitely a must-have in my eyes for a badminton player. The second thing super helpful for knee and ankle stability is a balance pad. You can also use a towel instead and fold it a couple of times to stand on it for different single leg exercises. But already for around 15 bucks, you get such a pad here that will make it a little bit more challenging, the exercises, and I'm using it almost on a daily basis. So for example, you can also use it during brushing your teeth, then you always get a few minutes per day, and that will help you to get more stable in your leg access. So now let's dive into the part about power and strength. And basically we can say there are 5 areas we want to train in. And on one hand you can differentiate between upper body and legs. And then upper body you have different push exercises, like for example a push-up, in comparison to exercises where you have to pull, like a pull-up for example. And you have the same thing for the legs. You have pushing exercises or knee dominant exercises like lunges for example, and you have pulling exercises or more hinge dominant exercises, for example like deadlifting. The 5th area is the core, and there we actually have a lot of bodyweight exercises that will do the trick. But for the other 4 parts, we usually get the problem that many of the bodyweight exercises only get hard after 15 plus reps. For example, if we do lunges without any extra weight, and if you're a little bit more trained, and you have to do 20, 30, 40 reps until you really get tired. But it is important to know that the effect of your training usually depends on the number of repetitions you are doing. So here you can see with 15 or more reps, you got a huge effect on your muscular endurance. But if you want to really build muscle mass, for example, you have to go for a range between 8 and 12 reps until failure of muscle. So you really should be only able to do around 8 to 12 reps before you have to stop, or before the quality of your exercise really goes down. If you want to go for maximal strength or for power training, you have to go even lower. So there, maybe even around 5 or even fewer reps is a good amount if you want to improve in that area. But you will see, even with tools, it gets a little bit tricky to get in that area. And it is also a higher injury risk, especially when you don't have a perfect technique for different exercises. So I would not recommend that to beginners at all. Only if you're very experienced, if you really know what you're doing, then you can maybe dive into that area. But yeah, aiming for that 8 to 12 reps, and this is something that's hard at some exercises with body weight, but with different tools you can actually do it. I already spoke about the pull-up, and actually the first tool I would recommend you to get is a pull-up bar, and also an adjustable pull-up bar that you can put in between your door and also put it on different heights. Once again, that bar is quite cheap. You can already get it for around 15 to 20 euros. And you can do a lot of different, especially pull exercises with it. So of course you can do normal pull-ups, but for example, also if you're not able yet to do a normal pull-up, you can also put the bar lower and then do it lying and adjust the difficulty by adjusting the height of the bar. You can also use it for push-up variations. So you can do inclined or declined push-ups, and you can also use it for dips, for example. And then one more cool thing, you can also use the bar as an anchor for your resistance bands. And that is tool number 2. There are different versions of resistance bands, but I think the cheapest option are these round rubber bands. So you can go for them, and also make sure that you get a set of bands with different levels and different tensions on the bands. So that will later help you to adjust every exercise that it fits perfect for your level, and you can get into the area where you want to get. So resistance bands are super versatile. You can use them for a lot of different push exercises, but also pull exercises for the upper body. But there are also ways how you can use them to spice up your leg exercises. So for example, split squats, lunges, deadlifts. You can use it for so many of these exercises. So basically you don't need anything else than the bar and a good set of resistance bands. If you go for the rubber bands I just showed you, definitely also go for a grip and something where you can click it in. You don't always want to hold that band in your hand. Especially when you are well trained and a little bit stronger, you need a little bit more tension on those bands. So definitely compare them, see how much kilograms and pounds you can get on if you also put them together and use them combined. I, for example, got that set of tubes here that you can adjust between 40 pounds and 250 pounds, always depending on what tubes you combine. So investing in something like that will save you a huge amount of money, because if you have to buy single dumbbells, barbells or kettlebells, they will cost such an extremely amount of money, and those resistance bands can do a lot of the trick just with one tool. So if we add up those essentials, the mini bands, the pull-up bar and resistance bands, also with a clip and a grip, we are around 50 to 60 euros. So you can see with that amount of money you can already get almost anything you need for a really good training and workout at home. If you want to spend a little bit more, I would recommend you to also get a dumbbell that you can adjust with the weights. Once again, that will save you so much money, because you only have to buy a few different plates and then you can always adjust the dumbbell to the weight that you want. And already one dumbbell is enough in my eyes, because all the push and pull exercises for the upper body you can do with the resistance bands and the pull-up bar, but the dumbbell is extremely helpful to add some extra weight on your squats, lunges or deadlift exercises. If you also want to go for a dumbbell, I would go for one that you can be adjust up to around 20 kilograms. In the end, two more tools. One, a nice to have in my eyes, very cheap, push-up grips. I like them because of two reasons. One is that normal push-ups can put a lot of stress on your wrist, and with those grips, it's a lot more comfortable to do push-ups. And the second thing, you can also go down a little bit deeper and work the muscles a little bit better, especially helpful for decline push-ups. And last but not least, a nice to have, especially for players with really strong legs, is a weight vest. If you do exercises like goblet squats or split squats, for example, where you hold a dumbbell in front of you, sometimes the core can be the limiting factor. So in the end, you don't have to stop because of the legs getting too tired, but because you just cannot hold the weight in front of you anymore. So here the weight vest can be helpful to put more weight on without having that problem with the dumbbell or the extra weight in front of you. The cheapest vests you can already get for around 30 euros. If you spend a little bit more, you can get a vest that is already adjustable, so you can put weights in and put weights out. So this is something I would go for in the beginning, as you don't have to stick with one weight of your vest all the time. So to sum it up, if we go for only the basic essentials, you are around 50 to 60 euros. If you have a little bit more budget and if you're also well trained and a little bit stronger in the legs especially, a dumbbell and also a weight vest is a good investment in my eyes. There you spend around 100, maybe a little bit more than 100 euros, and you get those two tools, also very versatile for a lot of different leg exercises. And as I mentioned, two nice to haves, the grips for the push-ups, and in the beginning I said it, a balance pad, both in total for around 20 bucks. So if you add all the things together, you land at around 200 euros for a really well equipped badminton home gym. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you also got some ideas and maybe some motivation to build your own badminton home gym. As you've seen, it's not very expensive. Already with a few euros, you can get all the basic important equipment to spice up your bodyweight exercises that you're maybe already doing at home. I already mentioned it in the beginning. On my website, you find tons of different workouts with bodyweight and with mini bands, as I said. But if you guys want some videos, maybe with exercises for resistance bands and pull-up bars, just let me know it in the comments below. And as usual, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel if you're not already following, and then see you next time.